Have you heard recently in the news about a breakthrough in breast cancer that better helps us determine whether you may or may not benefit from chemotherapy for your unique breast cancer? It involves breast cancer genomics, the Oncotype DX test, and the Tailor X Clinical Trial. Don't be confused. We will teach you all about it. If you recently have been diagnosed with a small, favorable, hormone-sensitive estrogen receptor positive and no cancer in your lymph nodes, early stage breast cancer, your breast cancer specialist may order, if appropriate for you, a genomic test called an Oncotype DX assay, a test that looks deeper into your cancer cells to better determine whether or not you may benefit or not benefit from chemotherapy in addition to hormonal therapy. Today, a large clinical trial just presented and released and published results in the New England Journal of Medicine that better helps us as breast cancer specialists guide patients with favorable early stage breast cancers that have an Oncotype DX test result in what we call the intermediate range. There was lack of clarity before today, and now we have better clarity to guide patients toward or away from chemotherapy. In this Breast Cancer School for Patients lesson, we're going to tell you about breast cancer genomic assays, what this information tells us, and how it can affect your breast cancer treatment decisions. I'm going to tell you what the new information from the Tailor X clinical trial provides us, and what it tells us as treating physicians, and what you must know as a newly diagnosed breast cancer patient. I'm going to go over how we now interpret the intermediate recurrence score results, which we have more clarity on now. However, this interpretation may evolve over time as we all learn more of the information from this clinical trial. And I'm also going to go over who may qualify for a genomic assay in general if you have been diagnosed with breast cancer. So let's get started. So what is a breast cancer genomic test? Well, these are sophisticated tests that we've been using over the last 10 to 15 years that help us take a deeper look into your breast cancer cells to better determine whether your breast cancer has a higher chance of recurring, meaning threatening your life, and also gives us information about whether or not you may or may not benefit from chemotherapy for your early favorable breast cancer. It is so important to state that the decision to undergo chemotherapy is one of the most difficult decisions in all of healthcare for your physicians, your multidisciplinary team, and obviously you as a patient. And a genomic test simply doesn't give you a yes or a no answer. It's a piece of a puzzle, a large puzzle, that is you as a human being, a person, and also your unique breast cancer situation. The Tailor X clinical trial gives us better clarity of those that have had a genomic test, an Oncotype DX test, and a lot of patients that would get that test had a middle range, an intermediate recurrence score. And now we have better clarity about how to guide patients, whether or not they benefit or do not benefit from chemotherapy. And I'm going to tell you about the Tailor X trial next. So what is the Tailor X clinical trial? Well, the results were just presented today, and they're published in the New England Journal of Medicine. But it is breaking news because it's powerful information that in general tells us that we can take more women with early stage favorable breast cancer, and in the future, give less women chemotherapy to get great outcomes. I'm gonna walk you through this clinical trial and tell you about something called a recurrence score. So the Tailor X trial, one of the largest breast cancer trials ever performed, took 10,000 women, early stage favorable breast cancer. I'm gonna go over who qualifies for a genomic assay next. But patients that qualified for a genomic assay, and they use the Oncotype DX assay to better determine some of the patients sort of in the middle that we weren't sure what to do with, offer chemotherapy or not. So what a recurrence score is, a score after looking deeper into your cancer cells from 1 to 100. And we already know from the Tailor X trial, they released some preliminary information several years ago, that if you have a recurrence score between 1 and 10, you have such a favorable breast cancer that if you take hormonal therapy, the chance of your cancer coming back in the next 5 to 10 years is probably in the range of 1 to 3%. No benefit at all from chemotherapy. The next group is our intermediate group. And I'm going to jump ahead and tell you that if you have a recurrence score above 31, we generally recommend, and there's good data to support, that you'll benefit from chemotherapy if appropriate for you. So now we're back to score of 11, and in this case to 25, an intermediate group. And that's what the Tailor X trial really studied. Do all these patients need chemotherapy? Do none of them need chemotherapy? Or where do we draw the line? So the Tailor X trial reported its results, and this is some general conclusions. If you have a recurrence score of an early favorable breast cancer between 11 and 25, in general, you will likely not benefit from chemotherapy. There are a couple of caveats. I'll cover them in a minute. If you have a recurrence score between 26 and 30, kind of that right below, you benefit from chemotherapy. We don't have clarity now in that small group, but it's pushing towards chemotherapy, most likely. But if you came back after sending off an Oncotype DX and got your recurrence score, and you're less than 50, meaning premenopausal or less than 50, a younger patient, then there is a small benefit to chemotherapy if you have a recurrence score between 16 and 20. It's small, but it's there, and they found that in the study. And if you have a recurrence score between 21 and 25, now the upper end of this intermediate range, there's a moderate benefit to you from chemotherapy. So it's small and moderate, and those need to be individualized decisions for patients and their medical oncologists and larger breast cancer team to make. But when we step back in this 11 to 25 range, we now can look at patients and tell more of them, you do not benefit from chemotherapy. Whereas in the past, we would have offered chemotherapy in some unique situations. So it really spares many women from getting chemotherapy in the future. Same test, we just understand the test better and we'll utilize it to better benefit to patients. And one of the things we talk about breast cancer is giving you what you need, but not over-treating. It's called personalized medicine. And that's what defines excellent breast cancer care. So who qualifies for a genomic assay for their breast cancer? Well, this is obviously a very complex topic, but I'm going to give you some general principles. Of all women and all cancers, probably about 25 to 50% of them may qualify for a genomic assay, but that does not mean it's appropriate for all of them. The decision to order a genomic assay is a complex one made with you and your medical oncologist and or your breast cancer surgeon. I'm going to give you a few concepts of those that do not qualify for a genomic assay. If you have HER2-positive breast cancer or triple-negative breast cancer, you're probably going to benefit from chemotherapy, and a genomic assay simply does not apply to you. If you have a more advanced breast cancer, an inflammatory breast cancer, we're going to give you chemotherapy anyway. Or if you have a very large breast cancer and multiple lymph nodes involved, you're going to likely get chemotherapy, and a genomic assay plays no role in your unique situation. On the other hand, who does qualify? Generally smaller breast cancers, 4 or 5 centimeters or less. Favorable estrogen receptor positive and HER2 negative breast cancers. And also a favorable sign is that there's no cancer in your lymph nodes at the time of surgery. There's some caveats about applying a genomic assay to someone who has 1 or 2 lymph nodes, but we don't really cover that in this discussion today. So, When you step back, a genomic assay is so helpful, but you need to be also willing to consider to undergo chemotherapy and healthy enough to undergo chemotherapy to justify ordering an expensive test. Because if you are not at all interested in chemotherapy, you say, even if, doctor, if you recommend it, I will never take it, you don't need to do the test because it might point to chemotherapy and it's not going to change your decision. Also, if you're unhealthy or would not tolerate chemotherapy, it's probably not a good idea to order a genomic assay. Make these decisions by engaging your breast cancer surgeon and medical oncologist and ask them about whether a genomic assay, whether it's an Oncotype DX assay, a MammaPrint, an EndoPredict, and there are others, whether they may play a role in making treatment decisions for your unique breast cancer. If you qualify for a genomic assay for your breast cancer, such as an Oncotype DX test, we can now better identify whether or not you'll benefit from chemotherapy with the results of the Tailor X Clinical Trial, of which the results were just presented today and published today in the New England Journal of Medicine. The decision to undergo chemotherapy is one of the most difficult decisions in all of healthcare. But this clinical trial allows us to identify more women who can avoid chemotherapy with an early favorable breast cancer. To learn more about breast cancer genomics, the Tailor X Clinical Trial, clinical trials, will I need chemotherapy, hormone therapy, visit the Breast Cancer School for Patients at breastcancercourse.org, where we actually teach you everything you need to know.
We're here to help you get the best possible breast cancer care in your community. Register on our website to get our list of questions to prepare you for your next doctor visit.